Our topic for this episode is Introduction to Criminal Law. Criminal law may be defined as a branch of public substantive law which defines crime, treats of their nature, and provides for their punishment. Based on a given definition, one can ascertain the importance of criminal laws. First, they tell us what are the acts or omissions which are prohibited or forbidden, and as such, we should avoid doing them. Secondly, criminal laws tell us how to handle or deal with every crime committed, depending on their nature. And lastly, criminal laws provide penalty for every prohibited act or omission committed in violation thereof. Thus, a criminal law is also called a penal law. When a person committed an act or omission in violation of a criminal law, he or she committed a crime. Crime is a generic term that may be defined as an act or omission in violation of a criminal law. Based again on the given definition, there are two ways a crime may be committed. First is through action, and second is by omission. Act or action simply means bodily movement or physical activity of a person. Examples of acts prohibited by criminal laws are killing of a person or stealing another person's personal property. On the other hand, omission may be defined as the failure of a person to perform a positive duty that is required by law for him or her to perform. Examples of omissions are abandonment of one's victim and negligence of parents. Depending on what source of criminal law was violated, a crime may also be called a felony, offense, or misdemeanor. As to the sources of criminal laws in the Philippines, there are three. One is the Revised Penal Code or Act No. 3815, two, Special Penal Laws, and three, Executive Orders. The Revised Penal Code is the basic and fundamental criminal law of the Philippines as of today. It is here where most crimes in the Philippines are defined, and is also a basis in creating other criminal laws. It was approved on December 8, 1930 and took effect on January 1, 1932. Many provisions of the Revised Penal Code were already amended or repealed. However, it still stands as the premier source of criminal law in the country. Special penal laws are usually those enacted by the lawmaking body of the government, which is the Congress. They are called Republic Acts, Presidential Decrees, Batas Pambansa, or Commonwealth Acts, depending on the form of the government when these laws were created. For instance, Republic Acts are those enacted in the legislative branch of a democratic government like ours. Our democratic form of government started in July 24, 1946, was interrupted in between, but again was regained after the effectivity of the 1987 Philippine Constitution. So all our laws passed after the effectivity of the 1987 Philippine Constitution are called Republic Acts. Presidential decrees or batas pambansa originated from the government or from the executive branch of the government at the time when the form of our government is parliamentary. History-wise, we are aware in what part of our Philippine history our government was a parliamentary government. Commonwealth Acts were passed by the legislature established by virtue of the 1935 Philippine Constitution. They are the National Assembly and the Congress of the Philippines. These legislatures existed at the times when our country is not yet independent from our colonizers. Ordinances, which are laws passed by the local legislative bodies like the Barangay Council, Municipal Council, City Council, and the Provincial Council, form part of our special laws. The last source of criminal law are executive orders. Executive orders are acts of the president providing for rules of a general or permanent character in implementation or execution of constitutional or statutory powers. So what is now the distinction between crime, felony, offense, and misdemeanor? This is a favorite source of question in the board exam. Crime is a generic term that refers to an act or omission defined and punished by a criminal law. The criminal law that defines and punishes an act or omission is the Revised Penal Code, specifically that is called a felony. Offense, on the other hand, refers to an act or omission defined and punished by a special law. Misdemeanor or delinquency is defined as simple infraction of law or order which are meant to maintain peace and order. In the Philippines, we follow the legal maxim of nullum crimen, nulla pena sine lege. In English, it says, there is no crime if there is no law punishing or forbidding it. This means that the basis in determining whether an act or omission is a crime is the presence of a written law defining it as such. We do not subscribe to common laws or unwritten laws which are practiced in some countries. Stating otherwise, an act or omission can be considered a crime only when there is a written law prohibiting or forbidding the act or omission. A person can only be punished for committing a crime. The law itself that was violated provides for a penalty. This is in consonance with the principle of due process of law, which is also exercised in our jurisdiction. More about due process of law will be discussed in the other sections of this lecture series. I made mention earlier about amendments and repeals of the revised penal code. This will bring us to the distinction between an amending law and a repealing law. An amending law is one that changes partially or totally a portion or part of a law. However, the amended law still stands. Like the revised penal code, there are lots of amending laws. Examples are Republic Act 10592 and Republic Act 10951. But still, the revised penal code stands as a law. A repealing law, on the other hand, is one that revokes or replaces an existing law, making the latter law inoperative or no longer in effect. Examples of repealing laws are Republic Act 9165 that repealed Republic Act 6425, Republic Act 10883 that repealed Republic Act 6539, and Republic Act 11131 that repealed Republic Act 6506. In connection thereto, please take note if there are amending laws or repealing laws to the law or the laws that you are studying in order for you not to be misled during your interview.